Hello everyone, let's introduce you today to the CIMPLICITY Advanced Viewer for OPC UA servers. In the past, we've supported OPC Classic server connections to bring data directly into a CIMPLICITY CimView screen. In recent releases, starting at CIMPLICITY 2023, you can now, in a similar way, you can talk to OPC UA servers alongside OPC servers and bring data in from one or more of these servers into SimEdit SimView. To do this, you need to edit the ptopc_config.xml file found in the installation directory under the data folder. So if I edit that config file, you'll see that we have some default setups in here. You have your UA projects, which is for OPC UA, and your standard OPC projects here. You'll also see a section for configuring the security aspects of OPC UA, which isn't offered in OPC, but OPC UA is a secured specification, both from a transport perspective and an authentication perspective. For this demo, we are going to take advantage of another file, a sample file that we provide right out of the install that gives you a number of scenarios that you might want to use when talking to OPC UA servers. You can see in the sample file, we have examples of an anonymous connection, a secured connection where you have your sign and encrypt protocol or policy set up, as well as the ability to specify a username and password versus anonymous. And as you continue on, you can see an example of using a user certificate for authentication, a Mac security option, and an option to actually connect to any CIMPLICITY project that's running its OPC UA server. So for simplicity's sake, for this demo, we're going to start a sample server with an endpoint you see here. We'll copy that endpoint. And in our ptopc config file, we're going to use that server endpoint. And to help us, we're going to take the sample anonymous section and copy it into our config XML file. And here we will use this endpoint instead of the one in the sample. Here. Now, if you're running locally, you can use placeholders like node name, or you can just replace the whole endpoint, which we'll do here. We'll save that. And because in this case, we are using no security policy and an anonymous connection, we don't have to set anything up with certificates. That will be part of another video that we'll share with you. So essentially, I should be ready to communicate to this OPC UA server directly from a screen. So if we go now to an example screen and go inside of SimEdit, and as I start it, I start it as a viewer because I don't need to have the full CIMPLICITY installed, just the viewer. We'll start this as a viewer. With the viewer running, now when I edit my animations and I go to browse, that anonymous project shows up and I see all of the IO addresses in the browse. Now these are a little cryptic because they're OPC UA addresses, and so far we are not using the browse names to look for them, but we can still use, let's say, for all the air conditioners. So here you can see the air conditioners that are in that OPC UA server. I'm going to access the humidity value. So having set that, if I go to runtime, I can see that I'm now communicating with that server. So there is the simple setup of the advanced viewer for OPC UA servers.